As a HOD of BVP and a senior MR specialist in the country, kindly mention few of your success stories in pediatric MR imaging.
I would like to tell you at this juncture that initially we were using a 0.35 Tesla machine from Siemens, and when we decided to upgrade to a 1.5 Tesla, our main aim was to reduce the scanning time for the children, because they are maybe 20 to 25% of the patients which we image. So at this juncture, when we were looking at a machine, what went in favor of the 1.5 Tesla from Philips was that they had the availability of pediatric coils, both the pediatric head coil and the body coil. So that was something which went in favor, and I don't think we've regretted the decision.
You have volume loads of experience in optimizing surface soil usage in pediatrics. Kindly give your viewers some tips and tricks.
What we try to do basically is to keep the babies and infants, as well as the smaller children, as comfortable as possible. That is by making sure that they are, we pad them adequately so that they don't move. Most of them are under sedation or under anesthesia, so that the motion artifacts are reduced. And we try to keep the scan times as low as possible and finish the study as soon as possible. The other thing is we have to keep them warm, because neonates are prone to hypothermia, and we have to ensure that they don't become hypoglycemic. In addition to that, I think the various protocols which Philips has set on our machine helps to make sure that we image them adequately. And probably because of this, the image quality which we get in the infants and neonates is excellent.
Any challenges you face in pediatric body MR at 3T? On 1.5T, have you tried the new trans non-contrast MRI in pediatric, auto-mesenteric and auto-iliac and renal MRA? Your experiences, please.
We have a 1.5 Tesla at present. I don't have any experience on the 3T. The non-contrast trans sequence we haven't tried in the pediatric age group. We've tried it in adults with good results.
How is the clinical application support at present? Any scope for improvements? Your message.
Clinical applications which we have, the support which we've received from Philips has been excellent so far. We haven't had any problems. In fact, I think they too probably are quite amazed at the images we get on our pediatric body as well as head coils. The other thing, I mean, one of the best compliments we could have got was that our pediatric brain images are as good as the 3T images. So I think that's saying a lot.
What are your advice or inputs to Radaxis or Cobra?
I think you are doing a great job, and you are likely to be doing even a greater job. So all the best.